Namaste children. Yesterday what we have learned, I have written on the board every day I am repeating. Now we have stopped at distance time graphs. Once again we will discuss about distance time graphs. So distance time graphs, graphs will be plotted between two variables. One will be independent variable, other will be dependent variable. What is independent variable here? Time is independent variable. Why you are calling it as independent variable? Any variable which will be changing by our choice, it is called as independent variable. So time in the graphs is independent variable. Whereas when we are changing this at our choice, because of this other variable is changing, that is called as dependent variable. The dependent variable in distance time graphs is distance. Now coming to the distance time graphs, the first graph what we discussed, in the first graph we have discussed what it gives. Already you have studied in class 7. Again we are repeating, distance time graphs will give the kind of motion. What is the type of motion? If it is a straight line, then it is called as uniform motion. And the gradient is increasing, so it is called as, the slope is going up, so it is called as speed is, in this speed is increasing. So distance time graphs describes two things about a moving body. One is what kind of motion, whether the motion is uniform, non-uniform, or the body is at rest. Then next thing is, they describes about the speed of the motion, whether the speed is increasing, whether the speed is decreasing, whether the speed is zero or the body is at rest. And also we can calculate the speed of the body through distance time graphs. Now if the graph is like this, distance time graph, it is a straight line, it is uniform motion. In the next graph, when you observe this graph, the line is from here. What type of graph it can be? It is also uniform motion and speed is increasing. But here what is the difference in between these two graphs? Here it is starting from the rest point, that is reference point, origin point, whereas it is not starting from the origin. So already it is having, possessing some speed. So this is also uniform motion, and because the slope is going up, it is speed is increasing. Next graph, in the next graph, what you are observed in the next graph, you see, this is time on x-axis, distance on y-axis. Now in the third graph, see, it is a curve. When you get a curve in the graph, it is called as non-uniform, what it describes, non-uniform motion. But the slope, again the curve is going up towards the y-axis, so the speed is increasing. Next graph, when you observe in this graph, what you can observe, you see once again, see, time on x-axis and distance on y-axis. Here the graph is parallel to the x-axis. Then the body is at rest. Speed is equals to zero. The body is at rest. Speed is equals to zero. Already we discussed speed may be zero or increasing, but never be negative. Now, so how many graphs we have seen in this? Now coming to the next distance time graph. Suppose in this distance time graphs, if the slope is coming from top to down, what you can say, its speed is decreasing. But it is a straight line, so it is uniform motion only. the speed is decreasing, so it is uniform motion only since it is a straight line. If in the graph it is coming like this, this is not uniform motion, or it is drawing your books also. Time, seconds, distance in meters. So the slope is coming towards the x-axis, from the top. So speed again decreasing. Speed is decreasing. Slope is a curve, so non-uniform motion. You can calculate by drawing the perpendiculars, the speed to the time axis as well as distance, that is y-axis, distance axis. Have you observed? Now the work is, this is the distance time graph you are getting. Suppose you describe this graph. What is happening in this graph? What kind of motion is this? And what the graph is describing? Okay. Now, next graph also you answer for this also. If the graph is like this, what it is saying? Is it possible in this type of graph or not? See, whether if it is possible, how? If it is not possible, what is the reason? This is the work today you have to do on the graphs, and distance and time graphs. Now again we will be discussing distance, time graphs. Anything graph is plotted in between two variables. The variable which is changing, which we are changing at our choice, is called as independent variable. Whereas because of this change, another variable changes, that is called as dependent variable. So in all distance time graphs, time is independent variable, distance is a dependent variable. Now when you are drawing distance time graphs, always you will be taking independent variable on x-axis. So time on x-axis, distance on y-axis. When the graph is a straight line and the slope is going up in upward direction, so it describes the body is moving uniformly. So it represents uniform motion and speed is increasing. In the second graph, and it is starting from the origin, so body is starting from the rest. In the second graph, the graph is starting halfway from the O. So it is not starting from the rest. So it already covered some distance. But the straight, it is going in a straight line, the graph. So it is also uniform motion. Speed is increasing since the gradient is in upward direction. In the third graph, what is happening? The body is at rest, starting from rest, but it is a curve. So it represents the curve, non-uniform motion. But the curve is going towards the y-axis, upward direction, so speed is increasing. In the next graph, what is happening? The line of distance time graph is parallel to the x-axis. So the body is rest, at rest, that is constant speed. So speed is zero. Speed is zero in this case. Now coming to next graphs. See, in this graph, the graph is a straight line. But coming towards the x-axis, so it is uniform motion, but speed is decreasing with the decreasing speed. Here also, but it is not a straight line, it is a curve from y-axis towards the x-axis coming down. So speed is decreasing, but the motion is non-uniform. Now, basic on this description of all the graphs, these two graphs you describe and write the results and reasons also. Then, this distance time graphs helps us to say what kind of motion the moving body possesses and what is the speed. And you can also calculate the speed from distance time graphs. Now we have discussed about distance time graphs. Now we are going to discuss about velocity time graphs. Here independent variable is time and velocity is dependent variable. So when you plot a graph in between velocity and time, if the gradient is, or slope is, a straight line going towards the y-axis, this is then this is the slope represents in the velocity time graphs acceleration. What the slope represents? Acceleration. So acceleration is the uniform speed and acceleration is increasing. Acceleration is increasing. In the second end, the body is starting from the rest. Same thing like the distance diagrams only. Here in the velocity time graph, the body is already possessing some speed. That is some initial velocity it is possessing. And the gradient gives the acceleration. Here also, it is going in upward. So acceleration is increasing. So positive acceleration we have learned already, no? So this is positive acceleration. Next, this is positive acceleration. Positive acceleration is positive. That means acceleration is velocity is increasing. So acceleration is positive. Acceleration also goes on increasing. Now in the next graph, these two cases, the speed is uniform, speed are uniform, velocity is because since graphs cannot give the direction, so magnitude of velocity is magnitude of speed is equals to magnitude of velocity. In this case, this is non-uniform speed. This is non-uniform speed since the graph is a curve and the body is starting from the rest. So this is also positive acceleration. Only acceleration is goes on increasing here. Next graph, the next graph, when it is parallel to the x-axis, this is constant velocity. Constant velocity. This is called as constant velocity. Now coming to this graph, the uniform speed or uniform velocity only, but the graph is coming down towards the x-axis. So it is what acceleration is decreasing. So acceleration is negative acceleration. What you will call this negative acceleration? In other words, retarding. The body is retarding. Already we have taken examples when you throw a ball towards vertically towards upward direction, it possesses negative acceleration. Same way, arrival of a train towards the station. Now, in this also, the slope is towards the x-axis. This is non-uniform velocity, non-uniform speed, non-uniform velocity. Okay, anyway, velocity time graphs, velocity, magnitude of velocity and speed you will be calculating here. So, this is retarding, this is also retarding. But the difference in these both cases is, both cases acceleration is negative only. But in both cases, this is non-uniform velocity, that is variable velocity. This non-uniform velocity, acceleration is negative. Yes? Have you understood? Now, one very very important graph we will be discussing today, so that you will be understanding. Now what you can do? Calculate from this. You can velocity time graphs, you can calculate whether the speed is uniform or non-uniform speed, or you can calculate acceleration, and you can also calculate the distance covered by a body. How can you calculate distance covered by a body in velocity time graphs? The graph under, the area under the graph, suppose I ask from here to here. So this is the, when you are drawing perpendiculars, what will come? What is the area? This is the area and this is one more area. When you add these two areas, you will be getting at this particular point what is the distance covered by a moving object. So the area under the sloping velocity time graphs gives the distance covered by a moving body. Now you remember this graph for today. It's very very important, velocity time graph only, so that we can discuss about the equations of motion in the next class. So once you carefully you see what are the parallels coming, so now I am drawing this from here. Okay. See, this is what it is, initial velocity. So the slope, take it as A, B. Okay. Take it as A and B. Now draw the perpendicular from the perpendicular to the x-axis as well as y-axis. Now put it as E. Okay. Now this is, let it be D. Okay. Now if you make this half, two areas are coming. You see. Now put it as C. Now what are parallels here? We will see. Only parallel lines here.
Yes.
the same thing, since AE is parallel to BC, BC is also equals to B minus U. Now children, this carefully you remember and learn these parallels. So tomorrow onwards we will be starting the equations of motion. All the three equations of motion one day I will be discussing with you. So be careful. This, if you understand this graph, you can do the equations of motion very easily. So when this, on this equations of motion only the whole physics chapters are depending in your 9th class. So please, once again, this graph is very very important to derive the equations of motion, and very very important, see, it carries one mark in any question. If the equation to derive is given, one mark will be given for the graph only. So again, you see carefully, learn, not down in the book. Again, we are going to discuss before discussing the equations of motion today. Thank you, children. Thank you very much.